YouTube, welcome or welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Michaela, aka Kay, and in today's video I'm gonna be showing you guys, basically giving you a tutorial on how I do my natural curly 4B hair. So let's get into it. Before we get into this, I just want to say, like, I know I haven't posted in a little minute, but I just want to, like, it is really hard to be productive and consistent on YouTube, especially as someone who's young and in school and not driving. So therefore I don't really have anything to record for you guys, but I am asking y'all on my Instagram stuff, what would y'all want to see? So if you don't follow me already, go follow me at Michaela Breon on Instagram. You can follow my TikToks. I have 2 accounts, and you can add me on Snap. And yeah, so in this video I'm gonna be showing y'all, basically, as you can see, my hair is a mess, so I'm gonna wash it, and then I'm gonna show you what I do, like, after I wash it, go into all these details, and I'm gonna give y'all some styles and stuff. 2 girls that I went to school with, or that I go to school with, asked me to make this video, because as a black girl with thick, curly hair, I'm not gonna say long, because it's probably not that long, but there's a struggle, you know, and trying to, especially going to a predominantly white school.
I'm in the tub, as you can see. I'm taking my ponytail down. If you hear King snoring, like, ignore that. I don't know. He act like he working 9 to 5. But anyways, I'm turning the water on, drenching my hair, trying to rinse all that product out, you know, get all the gel out and everything like that. So I use preferably hot water. I don't know if you can see the steam, but that water be banging. So yeah, I'm going in with the towel. I got water in my eye, but I'm going in with the Miel Pomegranate and Honey line. I'm using that shampoo, and I'm just gonna put a couple pumps in my hand and rub my palms together to kind of lather it up, and then I'm just gonna apply that to my hair. Just to get my hair, like, a little base, I'm going to apply some more shampoo, make sure I get on the kitchen, my edges, the back, all that, just to strip the hair a little bit more, and I'm going to scrub my scalp a little bit, but this is not really my, like, this is not me washing my hair, this is just trying to give my hair a base so the shampoo could lather up. So as you can see, I'm really rinsing that out pretty quickly. I didn't really let it sit in there for too long. Ponytail check, don't play with it. Y'all see the length. But I'm finna go in a second time with the shampoo, this time actually focusing on my scalp and trying to get the dandruff and buildup out of my hair. So I'm gonna rake it through, scratch my scalp here and there, and just, you know, detangle it and try to get my hair to look and feel good. I would say that this Miel product is very nourishing and moisturizing. Is really easy to detangle my hair with the shampoo in it, so that's what you see me doing, finger detangling. 10 out of 10, definitely recommend this product. Go shop now. So you can just see that I'm really trying to work that shampoo in. I'm really scrubbing my scalp, trying to make sure I get the kitchen, make sure I get my edges, make sure I get my scalp, all of that. And then I want to make sure I rinse the shampoo out really thoroughly. I don't know if y'all, when y'all wash your hair, do y'all get that squeaky clean feeling? That's what I'm trying to achieve here. Like, I want to be able to feel that my hair is clean. And I'm just going to keep scrubbing until my scalp is no longer itchy, I guess. And I do keep getting water and soap in my eye, so that's how it is on standby. So I'm going to do that one more time. That was me trying to tell you I was doing it one more time. And it was getting really steamy in there. So this time I'm starting at the back of my head. And I'm trying to show y'all that I'm getting the kitchen. Make sure I get the edges too. And I'm really just going to scrub. Like, my nails was, I was getting tired. My nails was bending and stuff. But I put way too much shampoo in there. But they, as you can see, it lathers up really, really good. And this is me cleaning my edges. But this is my favorite shampoo. It works so well for my hair. I go in my hair super, super dry, and I come out, like, moisturized, with it nice and moisturized and stuff like that. And it helps define my curls. That's another link check with the shampoo and and I like a troll, don't play with it. But yeah. So here I am rinsing it out, trying to make sure I get everything out because I don't want to go and like put product in my hair with shampoo still in there. You know, it's just gonna mess up the whole process. So I flip my head over to make sure I get the back all clean. My shirt is drenched, girl, but I wasn't finna put no bathing suit on. I really didn't feel like it. But once again, ignore King Snore. I don't really know what's good with that. He acting like he work all day, all night, but he just lay down. So now I'm getting ready to apply deep conditioning, but it's not really conditioner, it's a hair mask. It's the Miel rosemary and something line, rosemary and ginger, I don't really know. But I'm going to detangle my hair first. And I'm gonna apply the hair mask as if it's deep conditioner. If I wasn't to use this, my hair, I use this for my hair when it's really dry. And like say I went swimming and stuff like that, I use this to rejuvenate it, I guess. But if I wasn't to use this, I would just use the Miguel pomegranate and honey line conditioner. So I just want to show you that I did that all over my head, put that all over my head, and then I put it in four sections and I just let it sit while I took a bath. Usually I just let it sit for 30 minutes, but I just took a shower. And then this is me saying, oh girl, I got soap. That is embarrassing. Well, at least you believe me. I took a shower, that's why I got soap all over my neck. I don't really know what's good there. But I turned the water to cold to do a cool rinse to rinse the shampoo out. I mean the hair mask. I really can't believe I just got soap on me. Like, that's just so stupid. How did you not rinse the soap off? But yeah, usually I set a timer for about 30 minutes, but I just took a shower. And I know some girls whose wash days last about hours, but this only took me about, I was in the shower for about an hour, like 60 to 80 minutes, something like that. But this process only took about 30 minutes, not including the time that I waited with the deep conditioning. So I'm just showing y'all what the curl pattern looks like, and I'm wringing the water out. So yeah, it really didn't take that long, and my hair feels really, really, really good, really soft. It smells good and it's moisturized. But I'm just trying to get all the excess water out, and bless you. So now I go in with a shirt. For the shirt is dirty, so don't think I'm just ruining the shirt, but you would go in with a microfiber towel or a shirt.
And gel, and I just washed my hair. It don't make sense to pile it up at one time. So what I am gonna put in it for today is avocado moisturizing hair milk by Miel. Everything in this video that I'm gonna be using is by Miel Organics, but this video is not sponsored. I just love their products. But if you do want to get at me, Miel, get at me, bro. But yeah, so I'm just gonna put this in my hair. So you can see, like, it has its natural curl pattern right now. There's no product in it. This is just after me washing and putting in the hair mask that I use as deep conditioner. Oh, so I'm going to put some of this in. And my hair is kind of dry, so it's probably going to show up as white. But we're just going to put it in there. So you usually I would put some oil in it too right about now, but I don't have any. Don't ask me how I'm out of oil. But yeah, so I'm just putting this in for my hair. Just this ain't drying. It's gonna like ruin the natural curl pattern because I put it properly. But yeah, this is good for just So if you have oil and you're following my routine, I will put oil into, like, put it on the ends and your scalp. And yeah, I'm just gonna leave my hair alone, and then I'm gonna hit y'all back tomorrow when I try this out. What's up, y'all? I'm back. And as you can see, my hair has been in a ponytail. So I washed my hair on Wednesday, but I had to leave my house, and today is Sunday, and my hair been in a ponytail Thursday, Friday, Saturday. So I guess I have to finish the video now because I get my hair braided tomorrow. So let's get into it. So the first thing, you have to wash my hair again today. We're gonna have to blow it out. Anyways, I'm posting this video on Tuesday, the 27th. And I have another video coming out on Thursday, the 29th. So when this video drops, stay tuned. Yeah, my hair is so dry because I don't know how to blow it. But the first thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna show you my first style, is definition, so defining my curls. So the products that I use for definition is the Miel Pomegranate and Honey Coil Sculpting Custard. It's in here because this is huge. But the Extreme Pro Expert. Yeah. So, that's what this is. Don't forget. And I use any mousse will work, to be honest, but I have the Miel one too because I just love Miel products. And I use the Ondak Curl and Coil First Control setting mousse. But any mousse will work to be again, with this paddle brush, get you one. So when defining, I go in sections, I guess, not small sections, because I really don't have the time or patience for that. But I always keep some scrunchies on standby. And I just kind of split it there in a way that I'll be able to define it. And I'm gonna grab. Ow. It's like I don't bite it, I just grab it. But let me just show you what I do. I'm gonna show you twice and then I will be back. So, now I'm like a crazy person. First up, water. Water is your best friend for your natural hair. Like, you can never have too much water. Like, at this point, I have a towel on the floor because I just know water just helps. You need to drown your hair. Okay, so now that the hair is like drenched, hold on. Yeah, now that it's drenched, I go with the paddle brush. I just start at the bottom and work my way up, because if you start at the top, you just bring in all the tangles and the knots from the top down to the bottom, and it just makes it more difficult. So I've been doing my own natural hair since about 3 to 4 years now. I can tell you that it has definitely been a journey. Because before then, my mom was doing my hair, and my mom mom is black. She has, like, her natural hair is curly, but at that point her hair was relaxed, so she didn't really understand what worked for my hair. And then by the time I was old enough to do it, I really hadn't had any guidance, so I had to find out what works for my hair, what made it frizzy and all that. And like I said, it was a process. No shade to my mom, because she is a natural curly girl now, and now I can help her do her hair. But yeah, as you can see, it's all detangled and wet and stuff. So next, the way that you put the products in, the order of the products don't really matter to me. But if you want to copy it exactly, I literally change it every time. I don't know. But I just grab what's closest. I'm going in, well, I'm going in with the coral sculpting custard. And I just put some in my palm, rub that together, and then I break it through. I do this with everything, every product. I just rake it through throughout my hair. And don't think that because I put my hair in a ponytail and I had to use some gel to slick it, that it will affect how my hair turns out. So don't think that you need, you can do this on clean hair. But I will say, for me, this is the wet line extreme gel, whatever. I can say that for me, first day curls, like right after I wash them, never look as good as like if I were to do this on dirty hair instead of fresh and clean hair. So you can take that into consideration, because I have noticed that my hair curls better when it's dirty. Like, I don't really, I don't know, it probably holds the curl better. And yeah, so I'm gonna do this one more time, sped up, and then I'm gonna continue on the rest of my head, and I'll come back when I'm all done. Okay guys, so the hair is all defined. Honestly, I don't wear my hair like this anymore because it's uneven, it needs a shape, and it's honestly just ugly to me. I need my hair cut really bad. I got some damage going on in the front, but this is how I define my curls to prepare it for another style, or simply if my hair should dry and I want to define the curls. But some tips I can give you, this is all the shedding, that's about it. But some tips I can give you is, if you're someone who has damaged hair like me, you can focus on strands instead of sections. And if you have one strand that just doesn't seem to blend with the others, you can finger coil it or break more product through. You spend more time on that strand. Like I said, like, it doesn't really, for me, it never really depended on which mousse worked for me, because I've used Miel, Cream of Nature, Aunt Jackie's, you know, Carol's Daughter. Like, I was just, to be honest, as long as you know what the product is supposed to be. Like, this mousse specifically is for the frizz control, but, yeah, for me, I'm more of a volume girl than definition girl. I don't really care if my curls look like this. I really like my hair to be big. So, to get that, like, if you just want to rock your natural flow, to get that that look. I usually like shake my hair out, rake my fingers through the top to get the roots to be puffy. And you can also diffuse your hair, but most of the time I let my hair air dry. I've only diffused it like once or twice. In my whole lifetime. So yeah, that's pretty much it for style. So in the second style, I'm gonna be showing you how to do my half up, half down. Usually for half up, half down, I always define my hair first. So, and then I let it dry in the half up, half down stage or whatever. So, but sometimes like if I'm on day two hair, so I just defined my hair yesterday and I want to do a half up, half down today, I would just use the old dry defined hair drying because it would still have the curls if you sleep with your hair the correct way. We can get into that later. But I'm gonna show you guys. Basically, what I do is I don't part my hair, I don't really do the whole half up, half down. I just grab hair until it looks good. Okay, so next, you can honestly just, I don't usually do this, but for the video, I'm going to do it for demonstration purposes. But to get the other hair out of the way, you could just section it off. To shake my hair, I use Shine and Jam. This is the extra hold one. It doesn't really hold my hair. Be curling up, especially when it's wet. But I like my half up, half downs to look more natural than perfect. You know? I don't know if that makes sense. So I don't really trip if there's some hair that doesn't really slick down. But I'm just saying, like, if you're looking for a strong hold and you want your hair to actually be slick, then Shine and Jam don't really work. on my wet hair. It kind of helps curl it, to be honest. And don't use that that wet line extreme gel that I was talking about earlier. People probably use that for definition and not holding. Because in my opinion, that gel is a styling gel. I think it says styling gel. Like, that gel does not hold curly hair at all. In my opinion, it doesn't hold me and my mom's hair. I don't have type hair, type 4 hair, but I don't think it's 4C. So I'm going to say 4B, 4A, or maybe a mixture of 4B, 4C. But, and my mom, she has 3C, 4A hair. And that gel does not hold either of our hair. So that gel is definitely for definition and not holding. Okay, so as you can see, I have some waves. If you want a sleek hold, I recommend the Got To Be, not the spray, but the gel. The spray works too. They actually work really good as a pair. Oh, so yeah, most people don't really know. This is my go-to style because, as you can see, The front of my hair is damaged. From a leave out a past sewing. Yeah, the front of my hair is damaged. So I used to wear it down a lot in like a fro. But I stopped doing that because I honestly don't like the way my hair looks down anymore. It kind of outgrew its layers. And like I said, it's damaged. And it doesn't really have a shape. It's kind of flat. And I'm more of a volume girl than a definition girl. So then after I slicked the ponytail, I kind of just fluff my hair up until I get it how I like it. This is style 2, half up, half down. Now, the fourth thing I'm going to show you is not really a style, but it's how I do my edges. I do my edges multiple different ways, depending on the style or depending on how I feel, but I think that edges really make up a style. It can either jazz it up or jazz it down. So, in the generation or day and age that we live, big edges is really a trendy thing. Excuse me. So, I'm going to show basically how I do my edges. I can do them big, I can do them small, I can do them some swoops and all that. But for my edges, I use this. This is the Edge Booster Stronghold Water Base Pomade by Style Factory. I use the scent Pineapple. The scent doesn't really matter though. So this is number 3 or number 4? First definition. This is number 3. Number 3 edges. So first thing I do is I'll just comb out. So I have to stop saying so. But as you can see, my forehead is really big. So I like my big hairs to be big. Like my edges to be big. So it's not really my baby hair. It's like adult hair that I can pull out as a ponytail. But I just comb out all my edges. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to show y'all is basically my regular normal everyday edges. So I just take my edge brush and like build up in it and I dip it. You don't need a lot of product to be on it, or you don't need to stack up at one time. I just dip it in it, and then the first thing I always do is just brush the edges down, brush the hair down. In my opinion, it's harder to do my edges like after you've been wet, because like I said, I pulled the hair out of my ponytail, so it's been wet and sticky, I guess, compared to when it's dry hair. I think it's easier. But basically, after I brush it down, I start to use the comb part in my finger to form a swoop, and then I alternate from the brush and the comb to get the shape that I like. So after I get the shape of this, I take, you see how I got like this tail? I take some more edge booster and I just brush that off the way to blend it with the ponytail. Using my finger to hold down the hair, I just brush that away. And then I repeat the same thing on this side. So the camera cut off, somebody called me, but I just basically and then I'm going to do like my little sideburns. For that, I just brush them down and then like give them a swoop shape. You can like put some gel on it and then like make it curly. But my hair is uneven, so if I pull hair on this side, it's gonna be longer than this side, and then I'll have to cut it. This will be uneven. That's just not gonna work for me. So I try to make my edges look like sisters, but most of the time they look like distant cousins. That's the edges. So another way I do my edges is I keep the swoop shape that I originally did, but I take the tail, instead of swiping it up, I form a circle, a small circle, using my fingers, the rat tail and edge booster. I form a circle. it'll look like that. And then I do it to the middle edge and I do it to the side edge. But I'm not about to do all that. So I took my hair out there, but my dye is really cute. Like, I like when my hair, as you see, it's still uneven. But it ruined my dog sniffing the floor. I don't know what he's doing. King. But anyways, I like the way my hair looked after I take it out of a style, because it gave it some volume and it looked like it had a shape, but it really don't. But I think I'm just gonna end the video here. But let me just, you know, mention some things. I feel like in the natural hair community, you just honestly and truly have to figure out what works for you, because I went through multiple different edge control. This one by Mia, of course, and this one by Style Factor. I've used different mousses, different oils, different slicking products, and you honestly and truly just have to figure out what works best for you. Like, and I think it's good to keep your hair with like a consistent product, and honestly, the more you take care of your hair, the healthier it's gonna look, the healthier it's gonna feel, and you're gonna feel more confident. But you have to understand that, you know, like, it's a process, it's a journey. So another disclaimer, this, whatever, some things might have worked for me and they don't work for you, you may just have to find out what works for you. And again, this video was not sponsored by any of these product brands. But if y'all want to get at your girl, hit me up with the business email. So, yeah, thank y'all for watching. And let me know if y'all want to see another sequel of this, I guess, where I give you suggestions on natural hairstyles. This was just my go-to, I guess. And the style that I did do, someone asked me to do. If y'all want to know how I do my ponytails, it's basically the same thing. After I have a curl down, I use this, and I just gather up hair, brush it up, do my edges. It's that simple. But if y'all do want me to show y'all, let me know. But if you made this far, thanks for watching. Make sure you leave the video with a thumbs up, comment down below, and don't forget to subscribe. I'll see y'all next time.